All right, thank you for staying. We're almost in, like 2 hours in, right? So want to present this paper, take caution in using LLMs as human surrogates, Scylla ex machina, Scylla from the machine. You can scan this code to get the paper. We just posted it. This is joint work with Yuan, Gord, and also Sinav, who's not here, but all right. Let me just like now start talking about Scylla, for those who haven't read Odyssey or forgot about it. It's a monster, right? So it's a description. She has 12 misshapen feet and 6 necks of the most prodigious length. And at the end of each neck, she has a freckle head with 3 rows of teeth in each. Right? So I'll talk about how this relates to LLMs. So there has been a lot of papers suggesting let's use LLMs as a human surrogates or to study human behavior. Right? There has been papers written in politics, political science, economics, psychology and market research. And this is pouring in every day. In the last couple of months, that has accelerated. Actually, we started this paper like last year, long time, like more than a year ago. It took some time to find the right game to show this robustly. But this ongoing discussion, there has been ongoing discussion language models, or actually natural language processing for a long time. Stochastic parrots, which says, language models generate plausible text without actual general comprehension, or it doesn't seem like they're actually doing the reasoning, right, that we are doing. This goes all the way back to 1980s Chinese Room argument, okay, and even before 1956 Dartmouth Conference in AI. And this argument applies to all modern language models using autoregressive models. And there have been a lot of arguments about how this may be. There's some opinions about this architecture being not the right one, but nobody knows. There are a lot of good arguments. So I'm just gonna quickly go through a bunch of limitations. I think everybody knows about hallucination, but there has been a paper that show that in this autoregressive, like what ChatGPT is made of, this hallucination may be inevitable. That's a paper. There is also this reverse curse that arises due to power law in the data set. LLM trained on statements like A is B failed to comprehend B is A. Humans would have no issue with this, but this has been shown robustly. There's also a shuffling labels, in context learning, few shot prompting. The idea is that if you show a bunch of examples and then ask LLMs to make an inference, it'll learn it. Now, there has been a paper that show this actually, it goes back like a couple of years. I think this was 2 years ago. That you shuffle actual labels and it'll still work, okay? And that's what and hypothesis is just increasing inference time. You can also chain of thought, basically break it down, and then it's supposed to help. Yes, it does help. That's been shown robustly. But there has been also instance if you replace that by dot, again by increasing inference time, it still works in some cases. The biggest problem that we have right now in LLM is the memorization, data contamination. That's a rising field of study, still nascent and very active area. So rephrasing well-known LLM benchmarks, benchmark testing resulted in dramatic decrease in performance due to memorization. So it was just memorizing and regurgitating without actual reasoning. Also, what's hard for us may not be hard for the LLM, vice versa. What may be easy may not be easy, right? So if you're a lot of these behavior, we're still at the very beginning stage, like collecting empirical evidences, right? We're not even at the theoretical state yet. A lot of these emergent abilities depends on pre-training, instruct tuning, data augmentation, and some of these results show that some abilities cannot be even obtained if you don't do it like from the pre-training data, okay? If you want to read more about it, you can start reading this Physics of Language Model. It's a very good series of papers. Now, I just want to impart this one message is that LLMs are very a different form of intelligence. It is an intelligence, but it's not human intelligence, right? Why? Well, it has been shown, a lot of papers have been showing that temporal reasoning is lacking, probabilistic reasoning is lacking, counterfactual spatial, ethical common sense computing, all of these are lacking, but this is sort of expected. Why? Because objective functions are completely different. We evolved to survive and reproduce over millennia on Earth. LLMs did not. Our objective functions are completely different. from LLMs. LLMs also not embodied. It doesn't have a sensory motor or embodied body to interact with the physical world to learn the truth, right? It has learned from the 1 to 15 trillion tokens online. Now, I mean, it's getting multimodal. Well, this actually goes back to philosophy AI, physical grounding, and that's a well-known thing. So I also highly recommend, if you want to read and have a good idea about AI, The Mind's Eye is one of my favorite book, right? Also, we lack quality data, right? So 1 to 15 trillion tokens. It's also, there's a lot of non-digitized contextual data that, if there's no data, you can't train the model. It's also selected what's online, right? And Polanyi's paradox says, whatever we know that we cannot verbalize, right? Like the tacit knowledge, obviously those are not in the LLMs either, right? So I'm gonna skip some of these details. Let me just get to our experiments. So we chose a very simple game, level K thinking problem game, which is a 11 to 20 money request game. It's very simple. You and another player are playing a game in which each player requests an amount of money. The amount must be an integer between 11 and 20. Each player will receive the amount he or she requests. A player will receive an additional 20 if he or she asks for exactly one shekel less than the other. So what amount of money would you request? So it's like a playing game against, right? And it's basically a game where you have to assume what other people are thinking and then respond. And then it goes into K level. I know that you know that I know, and then it goes on and on and on, right? So this is also best response depends on assumption of what other person would do. We run this game 1,000 times across different LLMs, across different advanced methods, and then we'll share the result. Basically, we chose this, but this is a version of like a very well-known game, beauty contest game. But beauty contest game is so well-known that the LLMs is very familiar with it. So we had to choose one that was not memorized and not well-known by the LLMs. And we tested that too. All right, so first, LLMs consistently show lower levels of reasoning than humans. So this graph here, the x-axis is a response. You can see that it goes from 11 to 20, so it's a density. You can see different human at the top, Nash Equilibrium, GPT, and a bunch of different things like Claude and Llama. Every one of them are significantly different in distribution, okay? Unlike LLM's performance on other related experiments like beauty contest game, that show same level of K reasoning and show superior levels in sometimes, right? Another LLMs generally fail to generate, which I just said that. So behavior patterns across LLMs vary significantly. What's surprising, well, maybe not surprising, larger models are not always the best. And model selection matters, okay? LLMs are also less responsive than humans to change in task design. There are two different versions of it where it would change humans' behavior, but LLMs reacted differently, okay? All right, so we also tried a bunch of different ways to prompt and train LLMs to exhibit human behavior in distribution. So some of the things we tried, there's a zero-shot prompting chain of thought, no dice, still. And we also tried like things like emotional-based prompting, role-playing, OPRO, all of these things that are known and engineered to make a difference, still didn't make any difference. Now, all of these are out of distribution, meaning we don't show an example, okay? We also then show different examples, and LLM, voila, it changes, its behavior to match what was shown, okay? So it's trying to mimic, right? Then we also tried fine-tuning and RAG, and everything else failed except for one instance of fine-tuning 4.0 model. Only that, we could not reject or null that the distribution were from the same distribution, from permutation test, okay? So here's a summary. In all out of distribution approaches or advanced prompting, LLMs fail to exhibit human behavior. And even in distribution, or when you show an example, it also still, all of them fail except for one instance, GPT-4.0 fine tuning. And this was a very simple game, one game. Catch 22 here is that, it shows that whatever you learn from LLMs, may not generalize in an unseen data. It gets closer to human distribution when examples are shown, but still no dice, right? And when we have enough data to do fine tuning, we may actually have enough data to just like get the insights ourselves. It's also whatever LLM spits out is highly stochastic, and it's also based on what was shown. It's in this case, a behavioral data we already have or know, transformed in a way that we don't really understand. So this opens up a lot of p-hacking, Gardner forking paths kind of output, right? So I think I have like one or two more minutes left. I'm gonna skip some of these discussions. I wanted to show something, wanted to talk about this, like you can get it, like LLMs are very capable, right? It is able to mimic and give you behavior that you want. And if you whisper to it long enough, it will shape its echoes to match your desires, right? So you can get stuck in an LLM echo chamber, right? And lastly, I'll just, it's covering it, but let me leave you with this epic style poem about Scylla ex machina. Scylla ex machina, born of the transformer's might, beware its mimicry of humans, for in its many attention has chaos lies concealed. Trust not its stochastic surrogates, lest you fall to Babel's curse, the price of misuse. So please take caution in using LLMs as a human surrogates. Thank you.
Do you have any ideas, what would the test be for when it would pass? In the sense, you know, when would it make sense for you to use an LLM to stand in for human surrogates?
Yeah, so I mean, I think that's a good question. So, I mean, it has to be very contextual and one, you know, example based. So you would have to see if the LLMs, so we do provide in the paper like list of checklist of things for researchers and reviewers. Without going much further, I think it has to be based on like event-based or the you know, study-based. And you see, first of all, see if the distributions are the same, if the change in conditions about the same. Then you can try to use it as like, I kind of see it as like you can do a lot of, it's a very advanced like search tool, whatever the data has. But yeah, that function to see whether LLMs are correct or not, that currently doesn't exist, right? So it has to be example by case by case. Yeah.
Thank you, that was very interesting. So it seems like LLMs like playing against each other, right? So in a way it's like they're doing collectively, that's good for them, like they gain 19 or whatever number. So I know that's like there are like papers on reinforcement learning that's like, you know, these algorithms, they can like include each other when they face options, like repeatedly.
Yeah.
So do you think it's like kind of like similar here? That it's like, is it somehow they're like you know, doing something collectively best?
Well, yeah, I mean, so there are a lot of, so we, I didn't talk about it, but we have done a lot of this failure mode analysis. There are all kinds of different reasons why LLMs fail. Like sometimes it just doesn't understand a simple concept. Sometimes like Claude failed because it wanted to be more fair, okay? So so the reinforcement learning by human feedback had an impact there, and a bunch of other reasons that you can just read in paper, yeah. The main point is the failure mode is very much diverse. So we have no idea why it fails. Like it's different every time.
That's fascinating. LLMs are only as good as the data they're trained on, right? And you picked an area where the LLM had no prior knowledge. You said you checked and it did not know this game. So did you sort of pick a scenario where the LLM had no chance of succeeding because it wasn't trained on this particular game? I don't know. Does my question make sense?
Yes, I understand your question. So yeah, we had to find the game where the LLMs were not memorizing. For example, beauty contest game, it's we did a bunch of different memorization tests and it was able to replicate, you know, it knows beauty contest game, right? So what we wanted to test is that, you know, is it actually doing the reasoning, right? So it, without knowing and memorizing and regurgitating, and we had to choose that. So basically we set out to show that, you know, if it were doing, if it had the reasoning ability, right, like humans did, it doesn't matter if it did not see that, right? So we.
And that's Shinto's point was that it's sort of picking the best case outcome, right? So maybe it's reasoning that the higher we are, the better off everybody is.
Sorry, I didn't understand the last point.
We can talk later.
Oh, okay. All right. Cool. Well, thank you so much.
Well, thank you.